Hello chess friends and welcome to the channel. In today's video, one game from the semi-finals of the chess.com speed championship. The game is between Nakamura and Nepomniachtchi and was played online some days ago. The winner of this match will meet Wesley So in the upcoming grand final. The game is from round 11 and it's a blitz game with 5 minutes on the clock plus 1 second of increment. It's also a great game, so let's get started. Nakamura with the white pieces opens with e4, Nepomniachtchi answers with c5, the Sicilian defense. Here comes knight to f3 and d6. Bishop to b5 with check is the Moscow variation. Knight to d7, shielding the king. Now bishop back to a4 is already out of the main lines. Here comes knight to f6 attacking the pawn and short castle. A6, now played by Nepomniachtchi, of course the idea is to trap the bishop with b5 with tempo and then with c4. Let's go back one move and let's think, but is it possible to capture with the knight on e4? Let's try. Knight captures on e4, just a variation that I'm going to show you, is playable. But here comes rook to e1, knight back to f6, now d4, c captures, knight captures, and in this position, e6 is the most played move, because if we go back one move and we think to play g6, this g6 is low, and here comes bishop to f4. This pawn is pinned and white is already winning. So let's go back to knight captures on d4. That's why e6 is the most played move. But knight to b5 is coming, targeting with the help of the queen d6, and this move will start some complication, because here comes knight to b5, black will leave this pawn to his fate, will play bishop to e7 and doesn't want to change this good bishop with the knight. So here comes knight captures on d6 with check, and king to f8 with black. That is fine, but black cannot castle anymore. Let's go back to our game. That's why after short castle, here comes a6. Now, of course, d3 makes two good things in one, because it's controlling c4 so that the bishop is not trapped, and it's also protecting e4. Here comes b5 and bishop to b3. e6, because black need to develop this bishop in fianchetto. Now c3, clearing c2 for the light square bishop. Bishop to b7 is very good, and here comes rook to e1. Bishop to e7, knight in b goes to d2, and now short castle. With this move, the game is original, and probably black is also just a tiny bit better. Knight back to f1, c4 is a good move, because he's clearing c5 for the knight. Here comes d captures on c4, and b captures on c4. Now, the bishop and the knight are attacking e4, so instead of capturing this pawn, white decides that it's better to bring back the bishop to c2, saving the central pawn, and this is the right decision. Knight to c5, a new piece attacking the pawn, but here comes knight to g3, knight back to d7, and queen to e2, so the center is very well protected. Knight to b6, e5 now, bishop captures on f3, queen captures, and d captures on e5. The rook recaptures. Knight to d3 with tempo against the rook, with the knight in a very good outpost here on d3, but after rook back to e2, here comes queen to d5 with the idea of changing the queens and manage the game. But this move is not a mistake, but much stronger is to capture with the knight on c1, taking away the bishop pair, and let's see why. Let's go back one move. We said rook to e2, now much better than what was played, knight captures on c1. Here comes queen to d5 and queen captures on d5. Knight captures on d5, bishop captures on d3, and now this pawn is lost. C captures on d3, rook to d2 attacking the pawn, knight to f4 is protecting the pawn, but after rook to d1, the knight is under attack, the only defender of this pawn, so the pawn is lost. Knight to e2 we check, but there is the knight that is protecting e2. Knight captures, d captures, and rook to e1. Rook in f goes to d8 is a good blitz move, and so it's also a good move, but I mean it's also a good blitz move, because now if white captures, it loses the game. But after bishop to e3, now the second rook is protecting d1, and white at the next move can capture the pawn. Now rook in a goes to b8, rook captures on e2, also protecting b2. Here comes e5 and f3, f6, king to f1, king to f7, and king to e1, controlling d1. h5, rook to d1, king to e6, so improving the position of the king, rook captures, and bishop captures on d8. If we were in a classical match, this endgame would be, of course, won for white, but this is a 5-minute blitz game and anything can happen, because now here comes the fun. King to d1, the idea is to bring the king to c2. Here comes g5 and b4. Bishop to c7, king to c2 and g4. a4, king to f5, protecting the g4 square. Now, king to b3, so advancing where there is the passed pawn. And here comes h4. F captures, we check. The king recaptures. And now h3, we check, is good, because he's stopping the advancement of the h-pawn. So, king back to f5, now c4 is very good, advancing the passed pawn. Here comes e4 and b5. This is an inaccuracy, because, let's go back one move, keep advancing the passed pawn is the best idea. c5 and then king to c4 is much stronger. Anyway, let's go back to our game. We said after e4, here comes b5. King back to e6. King to b4, and now f5, c5, a captures, and here comes f4, targeting the bishop. Bishop back to c1, now this pawn is under attack, and also it's a terrible attack because the rook will capture, we check. So king to f5, away from the e-file and protecting the pawn. Now rook to f2, pinning the other pawn. And of course this pawn cannot advance, or the bishop can capture, because this pawn is pinned. So, king to g5, now king to c4, e3, and rook to a2, very good move, because the rook is still controlling the second rank, but also controlling the open a5. Here comes king to f5, of course the idea is to bring the king to e4, here comes c6, and this is a blunder. Let's watch why. Because in this position, rook to d8 is really boring for white, because there are no good moves. This rook, of course, cannot leave the second rank, so white cannot play rook to a7, or here comes e2 winning the game. King to c5 doesn't work, because there is bishop to d6, we check, king back to c4, and now again, bishop back to c7. Let's go back to this rook to d8. Rook to b2, also with the idea of pushing the b-pawn, also doesn't work, because there is rook to d1 and the bishop is trapped. So this rook must move back to a1. Bishop to a3, probably one of the few playable moves, also doesn't work, because there is rook to d2 and this pawn will advance and it's a mess. So in this position, after c6, if black continues with the rook to d8, this game should become a draw. Let's go back to our game. Instead, after c6, here comes king to e4, that is a missed chance. Now bishop to d2 and rook to d8 in this position is too late, because here comes bishop to c3 and both pieces are controlling d2. So rook to d3, in this position Nakamura should activate the rook with rook to a7 or rook to a8. Instead, here comes bishop to e1, and this is a mistake. Rook to e1 is the best move. Now bishop captures on h4 with the bishop still controlling e1, but here comes rook to c1, we check. King to b3, the king moving to d3 dramatically improves black's position. Now rook to a7, but here comes rook to c3, we check. King to b4, and in this position, live, Grandmaster Robert S. found a great idea in some seconds. So in this position, here comes rook to c4, we check, that is also a great move, trying to, at first, draw the game by repeating checks. But let's go back one move, let's watch what Robert S. found in a couple of seconds. Sorry. After king to b4, bishop to b6, we tempo against the rook, we checkmating ideas. This is a fantastic drawing idea, because of course now rook to b7 loses the game on the spot, because there is bishop to c5, we check, king to a4, and rook to a3, checkmate. So after bishop to b6 attacking the rook, white must find to draw the game, rook to d7, we check, here king to c2, now rook to d5, rook to b3 we check, king to a4, and after rook to b1 this is a draw, because c7 is good, because black cannot capture with the bishop, or the rook will win the bishop giving check with the fork. But here there is rook to a1 we check, king to b4, rook to b1, of course the king cannot move to the c-file, or really the bishop will win material, and so back and forth, this is a draw by repetition. So great idea. Let's go back to our game. After king to b4, here comes rook to c4, we check, that also is a good move. King to b3, rook to c3, we check, trying to save the game with a repetition. But here comes king to b2, and now bishop to e5, this is a good idea. Rook to a3, rook to a3 without nothing. And this is the last critical moment of the game. Of course, now black should capture the rook, because with rook captures on a3, not played by Nepomniachtchi, because of course they were playing on the increment, so with 1 second per move. Here comes king captures on a3, and now bishop to c7 controlling both pawns. This position, of course, king to b3 with the king that wants to go back to the center of the board. Now in this position, not king to d2, because here comes king to c4, e2, and king to c5. Now the pawn advancement will win the game. But after king to b3, the drawing move is king to e2, and it's a draw, because the king will move to f1 and will capture the pawns on the king side. Let's go back to our game. Instead, after rook to a3, instead of capturing, here comes king to c4, and this is a terrible mistake. Rook captures, we check, bishop captures, king to c2, and now bishop back to a5. Bishop to e1 is a beautiful deflection, because if the bishop captures, now this pawn will promote to queen. So bishop back to d8, and now h4, king captures, king to d3, king captures on c6, and king to e4, attacking the pawn on f4, king to c5, king captures on f4, king to d4, protecting the other pawn, but here comes king back to f3, king to d3, and g4, e2, g5 is good, bishop to e7, and g6, bishop to f8, stopping the pawn advancement, but here comes h5, bishop to g7, and now king to g4, with the king that, of course, wants to move forward, helping the pawns. But this move is a mistake, because watch this fantastic defensive resource. After king to g4, there is bishop to c3, we check, and of course this is a deflection, because if the bishop captures, king captures, this pawn will become queen, but also this one, and so should be a draw with the black queen behind the king. So in this position, here comes bishop to g3, but there is bishop to e5, same idea, bishop to h4, bishop to f6, and because the king is not here on f4, black can draw the game with this repetition, always repeating this deflection idea, and there is nothing to do, because in any case it's a draw. So let's go back to our game. That's why after bishop to g7, king to g4 is a mistake, but king to f4 is the winning move. Now bishop to h6 and king to f5, bishop to d2, bishop to h4, bishop to h6 and king to f6, king to e4 after g7. Of course, in this position, Nepomniachtchi resigns. But really, it was a very nice game to be a blitz game, with again many interesting endgame ideas. Nakamura also managed to win the complete match against Nepomniachtchi, and we play the grand final against Wesley So, but we don't know the exact date yet. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel, because tomorrow the Tata Steel 2020 will begin in Weekend Z with Magnus Carlsen, Caruana, Anish Giri, Wesley So, and all the other top players. For now, I thank you very much for watching and see you soon. So, see you tomorrow. Goodbye.